As your project begins to grow, the conversation of whether or not you want to keep everything in one project or actually break it out into multiple repos could come up. And there's a lot of discussion on the DBT discourse and the community about how you should go about that. The most common one is obviously the one repository, but what we're going to talk about here is how you could set it up to have separate repositories for teams or focus areas, along with one shared repository. And we'll do that by referencing multiple Git packages. So really what we're looking at here is how we can have one shared repo, maybe with some common macros or models, and then reference that in some of your other projects, but all within, you know, your same organization. I'm going to show just a very simple example of this. It's going to just have one macro, but the concepts are the same. I have this one demo DBT project that I've been working on throughout most of these videos, but I also have this other kind of random project that I have that I'm going to use as an example to say I want to reference a macro that I add in this project to my other one. And the way we're going to do that is like this. If we look at the packages documentation, rather than adding a package from DBT Hub, we're going to add one directly from another Git URL. Just to give you a quick overview, let's say this DBT music data project is the shared repo. And this demo DBT project is one of these other ones. We want to be able to reference something from this shared one, in our case, DBT music data, on here, demo DBT. What I've done is I just created a macro on here. I just called it new macro. It's very simple. It's literally just saying insert a value, hello, name, and print it out. Obviously, in a real scenario, you're going to have many macros with some way more complicated logic, but the process is still the same. So let's go and show you how this works. As it says here, we want to add a packages.yaml and reference it by the Git URL. I'll copy this here, and I've already created a packages.yaml here on my demo DBT. I'm gonna paste this in here, and here's where we put the URL of what we want to reference. And in this case, I want this DBT music data. So I'll go ahead here, grab this, copy this URL, and replace it here. Now, revision. This is where you want to put a tag or a branch name if you have one. Here it says they strongly recommend that because if you think about it, if you just put it to master, let's say, without any specific release version or anything like that, if you make a change to master and somebody comes in here and reruns DBT depths, you could have introduced something that could break it. So it's very important that you're specific. In this scenario, I do not have a release. So what we'll just do is kind of obviously against what they are just saying, unfortunately, but I did want to point that out. But for this case, we'll just say master for the sake of example. So now again, we're running this in demo DBT packages.yaml. We're trying to bring in the project of our other repo, which is this DBT music data. So I'm going to run DBT depths and it should bring it in now. We can see here it is giving us that warning. It's pinned to the master branch, which could introduce changes. You know, that's understood for this example. And now if we go to DBT modules, we see music data and we can see everything here. So at this point, we've now brought in this project. We showed here before that there was an actual macro here that we wanted, and it's actually not yet in the master branch. And I did that on purpose to show how this part works. Although I don't have a release number, I do have a branch. So if we go to add macro branch on here, again, we're looking at this music data one. Here is where I've added this macro. So what we'll do is change this to add macro. So that means it's going to look here for this branch specifically. And again, if you had a release number, you could put that here. So now let's rerun DBT depths. So here it is. It's now in here in our DBT modules under music data. And we can use this. We can now use this in our project. So let's walk through how to do that. I'll go into this example teams model here. And I'm just going to add this as a column. It doesn't really matter. This is a macro. So normally you would call this macro by name. So in this case, we've called it new macro with a name. And normally this would be it. If this was something that was in your folder, in your project under macros of your actual project, of your, you know, root project here, this would work. But let's see what happens when we do a DBT compile. we're getting an error and it says new macro is undefined. And that's because it's looking in this project that we're working in, which is demo DBT. It's looking under macros and saying, there's nothing called new macro, but we do have it here. And the way to call this to indicate that this is the one that we want, we have to prefix this with the name of the project, music data dot new macro. So that way it knows, look at this here under macros and here's what we want. So let's try this again. And there it worked. And we should be able to see this under the target compiled. And here it is. Hello, Mike. And that was from what we put in here. So this is critical here. Make sure that you're adding the identifier for the specific project. And if we look back here, you know, if maybe you have multiple repos, depending on how you set this up, you'll have multiple projects that come in here. Ultimately, a package is a project. And in order to identify the specific item or node that you want, you need to make sure you identify the project as well. Last thing I'll point out here is if you do not already have a gitignore set, you will want to add this. I think it comes default on a lot of projects now, but if you don't, make sure that you have, amongst these other things, DBT modules included here. So that way, anything in here that you bring in is not going to impact your changes and be brought into some code reviews, because really that's not important for this particular project here that you're working on. Again, very simple example, but the idea is the same, that as you want to bring in other projects, maybe in your organization, you know, different repos that you're working with, this is the way that you can do it, and this is how you reference it.